Have you ever wondered why plants and animals have camouflage colors, venomous spines, or migration patterns? These extraordinary characteristics and behaviors are called adaptations. An adaptation is a characteristic that can be passed down from a parent to a child in order to help the next generation of plant or animal survive. These adaptations can be structural, such as a physical part of the organism, or the adaptation can be behavioral, affecting the way an organism acts. Let's explore some of the adaptations of the animals that we learn about and that live here in the Butterfly House and Aquarium.
The first type of adaptation we'll explore today are structural adaptations. This is an adaptation that is a physical part of the plant or animal. Some examples include the coloration on an animal, the type of body part and how the body part works, or the chemical makeup of an organism like venom or poison. Animals with camouflage coloration resemble inanimate objects like rocks, trees, leaves, flowers, and grass. Through the generations, the animals that could blend in better with their surroundings had a higher chance of survival. These organisms were more successful in hiding from predator attacks or sneaking up on their prey. As a result, these survivors passed on their genes to their offspring. The animals without those camouflaging traits did not survive, and their genes were not passed on to the next generation.
Many butterflies use camouflage to hide from predators. They aren't able to actively defend themselves from predators, so their best bet is to not be seen in the first place. Leaf-wing butterfly wings have adapted to look just like a leaf. As the butterfly rests on a plant, it sits very still so it does not draw attention to itself. The predator does not even know the butterfly is there.
Similarly, a stonefish sits on the ocean floor buried in the sand or amongst rocks, blending in perfectly with its surroundings. The stonefish rarely moves, with its scales and body shape making it look exactly like a rock. Predators do not know the stonefish is there, and neither do prey. As a fish swims by, it does not even realize it is swimming over a predator, and the stonefish grabs its prey in the blink of an eye. Stingrays have countershading, which is when the top of the body is a darker color than the underside of the body. This helps stingrays blend in to avoid predators like sharks. If a shark is swimming below the stingray and the shark looks up at the stingray above it, the light underside of the stingray blends in with the bright sky above the water. For a shark swimming above the stingray, when it looks down at the stingray below it, the dark top of the stingray blends in with the dark-colored ocean floor below.
Some animals will adapt to look like another animal, giving them a better chance of survival because they resemble a poisonous animal, a more dangerous animal, or a non-threatening animal. This adaptation is called structural mimicry. For example, when a predator gets sick after eating an animal with certain colors or patterns, the predator learns to avoid that poisonous animal so it won't get sick again. Some prey species have adapted to look like a poisonous animal, so predators will leave them alone too. A well-known example of this is the viceroy butterfly mimicking the monarch butterfly. Monarch butterflies are poisonous because of the toxic milkweed that they ate as caterpillars. The black and orange coloration on the monarch's wings warn predators that they will get very sick if they eat this butterfly. Viceroy butterflies have adapted to look almost exactly like monarch butterflies. Even though the viceroys are not poisonous, they benefit because predators think the viceroys will make them sick just like the monarchs, so the predators leave them alone.
Some animals have adapted to have specialized mouth parts that help them get food in ways that are different from other animals. As a result, the animal doesn't have as much competition for food. Examples include the different types of bird beaks, fish mouths, and insect mouth parts. The butterfly fish that live here in our aquarium gallery have adapted to have long, pointed, small mouths so they can easily reach food in crevices between rocks. Butterfly fish eat tiny worms, corals, and anemones that grow and hide in those crevices where other predators cannot reach. This gives the butterfly fish a food source that few other predators are trying to eat, giving them a better chance of survival.
Similarly, the butterfly's proboscis, its tubular straw-like mouth, is an adaptation that allows butterflies to access fluid foods. Nectar, pollen, plant sap, tree sap, animal dung, and mud puddles are all valuable nutrient and mineral sources for butterflies that their proboscis can suck up. As a result, adult butterflies are not competing with their young for food because their caterpillars are eating leaves while the adult is drinking liquids.
The second type of adaptation we're learning about today is behavioral adaptation. A behavioral adaptation is the way an animal acts to help it survive. The animal has learned how to behave to improve its chances of surviving, often acting purely on instinct to ensure its survival. Examples include hibernation, migration, and behavioral mimicry. Some animals can be copycats, changing their appearance, their calls, or the way they act to copy another animal. When the animal looks or sounds like a different animal, it may help them hunt prey or escape a predator. This is called behavioral mimicry. Cuttlefish have been observed mimicking the appearance and behavior of snails and hermit crabs. Scientists believe that cuttlefish mimic snails and hermit crabs in order to protect themselves from predators and to help them sneak up on prey. If the cuttlefish looks like a snail or hermit crab with a hard protective shell, this is less appealing to a predator compared to the soft, easy-to-eat cuttlefish. Or if the cuttlefish looks like a snail or hermit crab, it may be able to catch more fish because a fish has no reason to be cautious around animals like snails or hermit crabs. As a predator or prey, cuttlefish can be a copycat to help them survive.
Animals around the world migrate to go to a new habitat to find food or water, find mates, have their babies, or find warmer weather to survive. This movement of animals every year is called migration. Migration is a behavioral adaptation that helps animals survive by moving from one type of habitat to another. Some animals travel thousands of miles every year, while others travel shorter distances or to different depths of water or different altitudes of mountains.
Kaunos rays migrate in groups of up to 10,000 rays. They travel south to warmer Atlantic waters in the winter, where they can find more food. Then they travel back north in the summer to have their babies in the safety of protected bays. By migrating, Kaunos rays ensure their survival as they move into a habitat that is warm, with plentiful food in the water, then in the summer to a habitat that is safe for their babies to grow with less threat of predators.
Monarch butterflies also migrate to ensure their survival. Monarchs do not have the ability to survive freezing temperatures, so they must go where the weather does not get too cold. These insects fly south to Mexico in the winter to a habitat that does not freeze. In the spring, the monarchs travel back north to find the milkweed their caterpillars need to survive. These monarchs lay their eggs, then die. Multiple generations continue flying north through the summer, and the migration south repeats in the fall. This migration is instinctual, as the butterflies flying south did not learn the way from their parents or their grandparents. Could you imagine going all the way to Mexico and no one had taught you how to get there? The monarch butterfly is acting purely on instinct, and their instinct is to fly south in the fall in order to survive.
Hibernation is another way for animals to survive the cold winter. Warm-blooded animals like bears and chipmunks hibernate throughout the winter, becoming inactive and going into a deep sleep. Their body processes, like breathing, slow down and the animals survive on stored fat. Some cold-blooded animals, like reptiles, have adapted to go into a deep sleep in the winter too. But this is called brumation. These cold-blooded animals hide underground, in rock crevices, or underwater when they brumate. Just like in hibernation, body processes like breathing rate, heart rate, and body temperature drop during brumation. The turtles in the conservatory brumate just like they do in the wild. Every winter, pond turtles like our red-eared slider and painted turtle go underwater to go into a deep sleep. Surrounded by water, the turtle's body temperature will not go below freezing as long as the water doesn't freeze. Scientists have observed turtles surviving well over 100 days as they brumate in cold water without coming to the surface. Pond turtles are able to do this because they have blood vessels under their skin that absorb oxygen from the water. One area where there are a lot of blood vessels? On the turtles' butts. So if you've heard that turtles can breathe out of their butts, well, it's true. Because turtles are cold-blooded, they could never survive the freezing winter temperatures in South Dakota. But with brumation, they have adapted to sleep underwater through the winter, then soak up the warm sun in the summer.
Animals have developed amazing characteristics and behaviors to help them adapt and survive. From fish that look like rocks, to butterflies that travel 3,000 miles each year, and copycat cuttlefish, we saw some fascinating structural and behavioral adaptations in butterflies and marine life. Next time you are out exploring nature or visiting the Butterfly House and Aquarium, see what animal adaptations you can discover.